Listen, guys, I just want to take a minute. I want to talk with you. Everybody hear me? Hear me clearly? It's echoing. Listen, I want to talk to you about the only reason, literally the only reason we do this. And that's because we want you to know what it is to have a Savior. We want you to know what it is to have God, the creator of the universe, in your life, involved. And it's so much more than religion. Religion is a set of practices. But this is so much more than just a set of practices. This is so much more than just a behavioral pattern. It's a relationship. Alright? And listen, I'm just gonna start at the beginning. Because I want to explain it in a way that is very, very easy to grasp. You see, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. You've read it in Genesis. And God created man. And he created man to love him and to be loved by him. There's a two-way street, a relationship there. But here's what we did. We rejected it. You see, God wanted true love. He wanted to love us, to lavish that on us, and for us to love him back. But for there to be love, real, genuine love, there has to be choice. And since in the beginning there was only God, then the only choice there is God or no God. And we, as people, chose no God. We ate from that fruit. For God had told us, this is what I have set for you. You can eat from all these trees, but I've just reserved this one for me. I've reserved this one. It's not good for you. If you eat it, you'll die. I promise you. Don't do it for your own sake. But we rejected it. We rejected the plan that God had for us. And we wanted the one thing we didn't have. And it's been killing us ever since. And here's the thing about God. You see, he is perfectly just. Raise your hand if you know what justice is. Justice is balance. Justice is the right thing being done. Justice is just when something goes wrong, something right weighs it out. There are choices and consequences. And so God, he is perfectly just. And so what has to happen, just as an illustration, let's say, I let you borrow $3. You owe me $3. Alright? What's your name? Mason owes me $3. Coming for it. He owes me $3. Now I have a choice. I can forgive the debt. You know what? It's just $3. Don't worry about it. And then I'm merciful. But what am I not? I'm not just. Because justice demands that the debt be paid. For justice to be fulfilled, he has to pay me back the $3. So I can say, hey, give me my $3, and he pays me. And then I am just, but what am I not? I'm not merciful. And here is the genius of God, that we sin, and the Bible says the wages of sin is death. And so we deserve death. And you know what death is? Death is the forfeiting of life. It's the giving up of life. So when we sinned, we owed our lives. And here's the thing, that debt had to be paid because God is perfectly just. His Bible says that he is. And if he ever did anything that wasn't completely just, then it would undermine the whole thing and we could never believe another word he said. But God always tells the truth. So when he says he's just, he is just. And so I said all that to say this, that sin, when we acquired it, when we committed the sin, justice has to be fulfilled. So we have to be punished. Hell is not a place that God created for people he doesn't like or people he's disappointed in. Hell is simply the absence of God. And when we choose sin, we're choosing, just like the very first choice there was, we're choosing not God. And so when we sin, God isn't rejecting us. He's not giving us the boot. We're giving ourselves the boot. We're turning and walking away. And that's exactly what we did. But here's the genius of God, that while God had to pay the debt, God had to make sure that sin was punished because he's perfectly just, God is also abundantly merciful. Beyond our comprehension, he looked down on our situation and he loved us so much that he decided, you know what? I'm going to take care of it. And so we racked up a bill. We racked up a bill of sin. And the only way to pay that bill is to die and to spend eternity separated from God. But there was hope in Jesus Christ. He looked down on you, every single one of you, and he said, I will go and I will take their place so that they can be with us again. So we walked away, and even though we turned our backs, God came and rescued us. What kind of love is that? It's an amazing love. It's such an amazing love. No human would do that for you. No man would do that for you. And so I'm here to tell you quite simply that we as people have gotten ourselves into a mess. But our God has figured a way out. And his name is Jesus Christ. And if you would bow your heads right now, just close your eyes. I don't want anybody looking around. If you're in this place and you would say, I want to know this Jesus. I want to have this hope. I want to have this relationship that you're talking about. Just slip your hand up and keep it up. I see those hands. I see those hands. I see those hands. I'm ready to make a commitment today to love the Lord with my whole heart and my whole life. Keep your hands up. Keep your hands up. Wow. Okay, you can put your hands up. I'm going to say a prayer. And if you slipped your hand up, I want you to pray this with all your heart. God, you can repeat it after me. And actually, everybody repeat it. The whole room, whether you raise your hand or not, just to make everybody comfortable. Father, I have gone my own way. But no longer. I've gotten myself in a mess. But no longer. Come into my life, Jesus. Change me and make me brand new. Adopt me as your son or your daughter. And be my father. I want a fresh start with you. I give you my heart. I give you my life. And I put you in place of Lord and Savior over my life. Tell me where to go. I'm following you. In your precious name, Jesus. Amen. Amen.